Hello friends, welcome to my channel, myself Parag Jambulkar. In this video, we will see how threads are synchronized in OpenMP. In last video, we have seen what is OpenMP, then how threads are created in OpenMP. We have seen how to get exact number of threads, and also we have seen how to allocate different work to different threads. So for that we use OpenMP sections. Now in this video we will see how to synchronize multiple threads. For that we should know one concept that is called as a critical section. You might have heard or you might have studied in operating system that critical section is a part of your program, or it is a collection of those statements where common resources are shared. So critical section is basically a block of code where common resources, and mostly those resources are our variables. So this is a block of code where common resources are shared by multiple threads. Now as multiple threads are running simultaneously, we may get inconsistent result, in the sense that common resources are accessed by multiple threads or their value is changed by multiple threads, we may get inconsistent result. In that situation, what we want, we have to synchronize threads, in the sense we want that only one thread should be allowed in critical section at a time. For example, look at this. Here we have created 5 threads. Now all the 5 threads are executing from this to this. So for first thread will execute from this to this, at the same time second thread will get executed from this to this, at the same time third thread will execute from this to this. Now see, all these 3 threads, they are incrementing the value of x. So there may be inconsistency, as the value of a is shared by all the 5 threads, and all the 5 threads, they are incrementing the value of x. But suppose we are expecting that all the 5 threads, they should increment the value of x, and initially suppose x is equal to 0 and we are expecting x is equal to 5, so we may get different result, as all the 5 threads simultaneously they are incrementing the value of x. Better we'll see one example. Now look at this. In this program, initially x is equal to 0, we are creating 300 threads. All these threads, they are accessing the value of x, and all these 300 threads, they are incrementing the value of x. What we are expecting, that x should get incremented 300 times, so finally x should be 300. But as the same x value is shared by 300 threads, now we will see the result. Look at this. We will compile this program and we'll run. Now we got 300. This time we got 298, 300, 299, 299, 300, 298. So see, same program when we are executing, sometimes we got 300, sometimes we got 298, sometimes we got 299. These are the different results we got when you execute the same program again and again. The reason is that when we get 300, in the sense all these 300 threads, they have incremented the value of x. When it is 298, that means there are 3 threads which have incremented the value of x simultaneously or at the same time. When we got x equal to 299, in the sense 2 threads, they have incremented the value of x at the same time, that's why we got 299. But we don't want that. What we want, x should be 300 all the time. But this is happening as this is a critical section, and all the threads, they are accessing the same value of x, and at the same time they are trying to increment the value of x. Now see, to get what is the result that we are expecting, we should mention it as a critical section, so that only one thread will be allowed to increment value of x. So to mention it as a critical section, we will mention like this, as per OMP critical. Now, this is a block. We are mentioning it as a critical section. Now, when you are mentioning it as critical section, so only one thread will be allowed to increment the value of x. Now, we are saving it and we will run it. First, we will compile it. And now, now look at the result. Each time we are getting 300. As we have mentioned this statement in critical section, only one thread is allowed to increment the value of x. So in this way, we can synchronize multiple threads. So friends, I hope you like this video. If yes, then click on like, subscribe to this channel and don't forget to press bell icon so that you will get notifications of my next video. So stay connected. Thank you.